Hey everyone, Christian here from CK Wraps. So we're gonna wrap the roof on this Genesis right here. We're using satin black for the roof. This is Avery satin black. This is not Vivid. You'll know that this is Avery because of the lack of branding on the backing paper. There's no lines, there's no nothing. It's completely blank. It's also got a bit of a distinct smell to it. So once you use Avery, you'll know right away if you ordered Avery, if you bought it online, or if you got some fake stuff. If you've used it before, you'll know by just by the smell of it. Same with 3M, same with Vivid, they all have kind of distinct smells to them. So it's also an extremely soft and pliable film. And Andrew is actually gonna do the roof wrap. I'll do some of the trimming, but Andrew's gonna do the roof wrap. So Avery's super flimsy stuff. Like it's really enjoyable to work with. It's almost at a point where it's kind of too thin, but it works really well once you get the hang of it. It's great beginner vinyl to use. I always recommend it. Fairly affordable as well. The air release works really well. It does show some adhesive lines, so it does show some glue lines when the temperatures are hot. Those are kind of unavoidable. They're even more predominant in 3M. There's actually none in Vivid, so which is kind of their thing. Doesn't show it at all in Vivid. I've never seen a glue line in my life. But, so the finish is actually a little bit nicer on Vivid than it is on this, but Vivid doesn't have a satin black like this, so we're using Avery. All right, so we've got the surface prepped with isopropyl alcohol, wipe the entire thing down, blowing away all the dust with a compressor. Andrew will have his squeegee and blade ready, and I'm gonna do the recording with some of the narration, and the piece is already cut and laid down on the roof, so we're gonna get to it. I'm gonna take over the camera.
Let's just start it.
All right, and Andrew's gonna remove the backing. So this is Andrew's, basically his first roof wrap solo. So give him a break. He's new at this. So he's been learning with me a lot. He's actually been learning on chrome a lot, which is a really difficult thing to learn on. But needless to say, he's still learning. So it's really good. No, you'll be fine. So one thing Andrew forgot to do is stick a magnet down here just in case. So I'm gonna stick that there. There we go. I'm gonna assist him by removing the magnet from here. I'm gonna let him do all the peeling though. It's all right, so it's a little bit bunched up there, but he won't have a problem. It'll be fine. Yep. So he's gonna glass this out. And he's gonna do this without using any heat. So Avery is a pressure sensitive film. That means it doesn't stick pretty much at all until you add pressure to whatever it's touching. So look at that, that's already glassed out on the other side there. Sorry for the focus on the camera. The light's in the hitting the lens. So he's got his magnets down on the other side. He's gonna glass out this side right here. So he's pulling out with his hands. He's gonna read the wrinkles and he's gonna draw them out to the, yep, there you go, to the ends, just like that. So easy, guys. Like, again, do the same thing over here. He's gonna draw them out. Now there's a bit more curvature in the front, so it takes a bit more pressure. And that's it. So we've got a glassed roof right now. It looks like it's laid, but it's not. This is just, that's where the gap is. Not a big deal. But the rest of the roof is completely glassed. So he's gonna start squeegeeing from the center. And work towards himself. Now, however way he does this, if he goes end to end or a bit at a time, he wants to, if he wants to do this in triangles, totally up to him. But right now it's completely glass, so it's not really even necessary to do this in triangles. It doesn't really matter. The film's not going to wrinkle up for the most part.
So glass, it's hard to see the
Yeah, it's so yeah. So what he said was, it's, I'm not sure if you heard him, but he said it's so glassed already that he can't even see the air line. So this is why, or sorry, where the air is and where he's already laid. So this is why you need to overlap your strokes and make sure you're being thorough. Because if you leave air under there, we're going to run into problems down the road. As soon as you take it outside and it hits the sunlight, it's going to bubble up. So one way to check afterwards to see if there is air under the film is to run a heat gun over it before you even take it outside. So as soon as air has moisture in it, and as soon as you add heat to any air pockets or air bubbles, they'll expand, which will show the bubble. Yeah, there's a dent. There's actually a dent in the roof right there. Everyone can see it. I'm not sure what happened. Looks like a meteor fell out of the sky and hit him. So Andrew's got a bit of a bubble here, which I saw already. It's not a big deal. There's a wrinkle there, but here, lift it.
Can you squeeze that out?
I don't know. But you can just lift this.
Maybe want to add some heat to that.
No, push down hard on it.
That's good.
Yeah, it's gone. So you just push down hard on that wrinkle and add a little tension to the film and it's gone. This is a super easy film to work with, guys. You know, like, it's probably my favorite. It will always be my favorite. We get a lot of requests for Vivid, so we use a lot of Vivid, and we're good at using Vivid, and we like using Vivid as well. It's just, it offers a different finish and has its own technical components as far as the way it works. So he's overlapping his strokes. And you can see slightly where the air is right over here and where we've already laid down over there. But even with the best lighting, it can still be difficult. We have a lot of lighting in here, so. Yeah, you can do it that way too. Where you're just doing it. So as with most films, Avery is self-healing, so if there are minor buffer lines or from squeegeeing, they usually post-heat out. So you throw it outside in the sun for 15, 20 minutes, it should be all gone and on a hot day. So Andrew has yet to do this by himself. That's coming along really well. Yep, so what he's gonna do is he's gonna bridge this gap pretty much, leave some tension over it. And then that way we don't have to cut on the car. And you're gonna leave about a centimeter. So you're gonna run your blade about halfway in this gap here. So see this edge here?
Yeah.
Sorry, this edge right here, which is where the clip goes for the roof trim. You're gonna cut on the inside, like kind of on the inside of that. So you can kind of start your blade there to get a feel for it, but you only need to leave about a centimeter or so, a quarter of an inch to a centimeter to fold over. I'm gonna do the front and rear window trim areas because those are super tight on this vehicle. They kind of vary from vehicle to vehicle. Sometimes they're loose, sometimes they're tighter. Even on the Genesis, it can be, we just did a roof wrap like a few days ago and it was super easy to get underneath the trim that runs across the back window and the front window. But on this one, for whatever reason, it's much tighter. So, you know, just car manufacturers, it's not always exactly the same. Yep, so you look good there. Just keeps the tension over it. You should be good. Yeah, use your thumb and then round that off. Yep, there you go. So we're not only doing the roof in satin black, we're going to be doing the spoiler in satin black also. Kind of tie it in a little bit. Yep. So take your finger and use your finger as a guide.
Let me just make sure I got a sharp blade.
Yep. Use your finger as a guide on the edge there. Your finger you can create the spacing with your finger, right? So I can put my finger on the edge of the roof, and then I can put the blade wherever I want on my finger, creating the spacing that I need, and it'll hold it very steady while we cut. I'm gonna let Andrew do that, but that's the idea.
And the glove makes that easy to do.
Yeah, and the glove makes it so his hand will glide a little bit more effortlessly. Perfect. So we always try to make it as straight as possible. If it isn't, not that big of a deal. This is completely covered by the roof trim, which is called a drip sill, I believe. This is the drip sill area, and that's drip sill trim. You can come right off on the glass, basically. Shouldn't be a problem. Yep. Perfect. Watch the front. Good, perfect. So he's going to try to do this in basically one sweeping motion. So as long as we have full coverage, we're good, and we do. So this is an easy roof. There's no sunroof, just a shark fin antenna to remove. That takes about 10 minutes on this car. It's not a big deal.
Super easy.
Yeah.
And it's really the material. If it was chrome or something with a stickier adhesive, it would be way more difficult to use. I've practiced a lot on it, and this is very fun to wrap with.
This is Andrew's favorite film too. All right, so I'm gonna finish this off. Andrew's gonna take over the camera, and I'm gonna finish off the front and rear window. So I know that for here, the window trim comes up pretty high. You can always double check it though. We wanna make sure that we have full coverage though. So I'm gonna push it down a little bit here. Just up to the line of it. That way, I know we're gonna have full coverage. So I'm just running my squeegee on the top side of that window trim, but I'm actually gonna tuck it in, even though it's gonna be difficult to tuck in because it's so tight. So I'm gonna start by trimming this off, and I'm gonna trim on the glass side. So I'm gonna trim on the glass side, leaving about an eighth of an inch. That's just my hands sticking to the film, that sound. All right, let's get the other side.
Look at that cut. Yeah.
So I know this is gonna be a mission to tuck this in, because we've already tried to see how tight the seal is. Rounding off the corner. All right. Finish up the rest of this. Again, on the glass side. All right. I'll do the tucking afterwards. So we're into this side here. Now this side, this piece comes up really high. So I don't really need to push it down towards the seal. I know the seal runs up really high to the roof. Okay. I'm also, while I'm here, going to cut this guy out. And I like to grab it and pull this piece out. I'll hold on to it. Sorry if I'm blocking the way. I'm gonna try not to block the way, but I'm adding tension to it. That way I can cut it out and remove it completely. That way I'm not pushing it into the car. Okay. Cool. Let me grab a triangle.
Right here.
Yeah, right there. All right, one of my favorite tucking tools, the tinting triangle, or tinter's triangle. I don't really think anything beats it for me. It's my favorite. I use it for all kinds of things.
I'm gonna try to get a good angle.
Yep. So I'm gonna lift and push in, lift and push in, lift and push in. I'm actually going to get a different squeegee because this one isn't firm enough.
Just so people can see.
What's that?
Just showing the lip. Yeah.
When we're running this through here, we have to be careful because you can actually snag your rubber seal here and cause damage to it. So just be careful. It should run pretty effortlessly through there. If you have to push hard, it may mean that you're not really positioned properly with the triangle, so you may have to move it this way or this way, depending. So this is a more firm squeegee. I've probably had this squeegee for like 5 years, this particular one. It just never wears out. Okay. I'm gonna move over to the other side, and you can probably just continue the videotape there, so you can get that. Mm-hmm. So the front one is probably gonna require a little bit more force with the triangle. Depending on how much film I have to tuck into there, because I know I've left a bit behind. So with a roof wrap like this, we never have to worry about anything getting underneath the roof wrap. So it's gonna be super easy. Now, I'm just gonna try to start this from this side. You can videotape from that side. Let me try and get this going though. It's really tight. Actually, this side's not bad. It's a good place to start. So the window's off. I know this car's been in an accident. It has a repainted front bumper, repainted mirror. So probably replace the windshield. I assume the airbag deployed may have shattered the windshields. So this side's actually super slack. I'm just going down about 2 inches at a time, tucking it in. And this is just my way of how I do it. There will be other installers with their own techniques on how they do it. I'm just kind of trying to teach you guys more at a beginner level so that you can see how, more or less, how you're supposed to do it. All right, so this is gonna get, I can feel it already getting much tighter over here. So I have to bend this back and kind of sweep with the squeegee. Just with the corner of it, it's all about all I can get in there right now. And this just popped out. So let me get this back in here. That's super tight over on this side. All right. We're almost there though. Okay, I lost it. Let me try and get it back in somewhere here. Let's try down here. I've seen a lot of roof wraps done where people don't tuck it in and it really ends up peeling back. So I do recommend doing it. Kind of figure it out if you have to and how to do it, but I really recommend doing it. A lot of the front of the car goes through a lot of hazardous conditions, so rain, high mile per hour winds, snow, whatever, you name it. So here because it's so tight. Jeez. It's not often that I have to use two triangles, one to run down the window trim, the other one to do the tucking. Could probably use the other one right now, but it's fine. I'll do it with this. Because we're almost there. Sorry if you can't see, it's really difficult to show you with my hands in the way. All right, so this came out accidentally again.
Open it from that side, or?
It won't be as easy to go from that side. So almost there though. There, I got it. Okay. I think I got it. Little bit more. All right. All right, got it. All right, so there is no white showing anywhere. Everything's tucked in really nicely. And there isn't any slack sitting inside that antenna. So when we go put the antenna back on, we don't have vinyl sitting in there. It's kind of a pet peeve of mine. Same with like the washer jet areas. Don't make sure you cut that out and then pull the vinyl out. It's just lazy not to. All right, and that's the roof rack. I can show you how to do the antenna. I do these antennas in two pieces, one main piece over the top and one piece on the back. I can show you how to do that for a shark fin antenna. Not all shark fin antennas are created equal. This one's a bit more difficult as far as shark fin antenna goes. But yeah, I can show you how to do that, and that's the roof wrap. So Andrew did most of that roof wrap. I just finished it up, and that's it. If you want to see more detailed pictures and videos, guys, please check out our Instagram or Facebook. We do post up completed projects and whatever else on there that you may not see on YouTube. These are just mostly solely instructional videos for your benefit. So anyways, thanks everyone. Take care.